Okay, so here we go. It is the final boss of the game. And let me just see if I can actually get the benefit of having an actual sound. Yeah, sorry, I recorded this without being able to like listen to the sound, and I am very curious to see what the sound is like here. Oh, that didn't... What? Press this button again. Is something going on? Yeah, I'm hearing stuff now. So, yeah. This is the final boss of Chained Echoes. I have to admit, the final boss marathon, I approve. It was satisfying. Maybe not super challenging, although, well, I obviously got my ass handed to me at least once. But in these fights, I mean, beyond the first one, I didn't really struggle with anything. I mean, yes, I kind of did come into the fight with ultimate weapons and whatnot, high levels all around, but I did not make special preparations for this. I just used whatever I had on hand, whatever was convenient. I mean, if it worked, it works. That's just fine. But Shin Megami Tensei would have annihilated my ass by this time. By this point. So, on the whole, I appreciate the game being nice to me. Well, what better way to celebrate the grand finale of the game? But with some matcha followed by the best damn green tea I have ever had within my homes. Really well done, developers. Yeah, I did actually check the credits, and although I will, by sheer ignorance, by the way, interrupt the credits before all the Kickstarter backers come in, yeah, they were not many who did this, who made this game, and I don't you compare to some other games, and I mean, the best I can think of is the closest thing I can think of is A Journey Down, or The Journey Down, right? It's The Journey. I think the core development team, without the voice actors and the like. There were three people. This game uses fewer people than that. Now, Matthias Linda was not the only one, but this was a low-man effort. And it had absolutely no business at all being as good and as enjoyable as it was. Yeah. I mean, studios, publishers, hire this guy. Hire the entire team. For fuck's sake. Just do it. Don't ask. Just give him a position and let him have at it. Have at it. Now, I was a little confused there by the by how everything went dim. But it does seem like it's actually not a glitch, or I'm just being dumb. That is the game doing a thing. Right, and there's my Linux PC warning me that I only have so much disk space left on the root partition. All these backups and kernel shenanigans. So, yeah. Killian gives you assistance in some spots. Kind of. I don't think that was the best idea they had, or at least the best implementation of all the ideas they did have, but... doesn't break the game. I am very much okay with what I have, what we got with this game. Like I said, and I do stand by that. Good damage though. Wow. Yeah, breaking is very good. Combine breaking with offensive buffs and yeah. Double the fun. Well, to be honest, I don't know what to talk about right now, so I'll just not say very much until something more interesting happens. Yeah, I will speak more when the end credits start rolling, or during the final cutscene. Surprise, not game over. Shin Megami Tensei would not have been this kind. I should probably point out that I'm not complaining about that, just pointing out a very big difference between this game and some others we could name. And surprise, win me. Okay, well, this comes a bit out of left field. Is this a Final Fantasy VIII reference? Oh, this ending is really nice. Yeah, something seems a little bit familiar about this, wouldn't you say? And there's our credits. So yeah, those are the three names that are basically the entire crew. Minus the voice actors and a few sound people, I think. And yeah, the vocalist. Again, this game is, considering how few people worked on it, so much better and so much more complete than it has any right to be. I can only hope that they worked with a finished engine or had some ready-made plugins or other assets they could build upon, and that they did so. And I mean, look at this, they even hired a localization studio. Or, oh wait, no, that's one person. Right, there are quite a lot of themes coming to this game and a whole lot of others. And I felt that the ending kind of drew on both, seems like episode 2 and 3 to a degree, and I mean, the bit where they ran out of the place, that was just seems like episode 1 all over. I am so here for that. Give me your Seattle Saga reference, I will love you forever. Also mechs. I'm simple that way. So yeah, I think I've said quite enough over the last few episodes about what may be coming down the tube, or down the pipe, along the line, in time. What you will see first, I think, is going to be a let's play of Four Last Things, the prequel to Procession to Calvary, an absolutely absurd and insane point-and-click adventure game. And I expect that Four Last Things will only be slightly less insane. I expect a lot of laughter out of that one. I did also imply that there may be a bigger scripted thing going on. I won't tease it, just in case it doesn't, I won't say what it is, in case, you know, choke, pretty much, if I don't come through all the way. but I can say that I at least intend to start on that project. Beyond that, Actually, I may be doing a poll of sorts on the channel, so... Well, I mean, it won't really matter in terms of, well, the video I get, but it will affect, how easy it is for me to, make the stuff happen, get the recording. Well, I think that is it. The end credits are about to stop, or so I think, but I will end them pretty soon. And then comes about 14 minutes of Kickstarter backing, and I was not one of them. To my great regret. I would have loved to fund this. Alas, I missed my opportunity. So I got to pay full price for this instead. There you go. Stay tuned. I'm not ending the channel just yet.